Hey, what's up, everybody? It's Agamotto here. Today, I'm going to be asking the question, what is the most brain-dead class in Rogue Lineage? And this is for Gaia, by the way. So for starters, we actually have to think about what the definition of brain-dead actually is. Like, a lot of people say, oh, that shit's brain-dead, but they don't actually, like, know what they're saying. They just kind of say it as, like, a buzzword. Like, a lot of people usually refer to how easy the class is. So automatically, a lot of people think, oh, well, Abysswalkers are the most brain-dead. I think a lot of people, like, miss or they don't realize that it's also, like, yo, it's actually got to be kind of good or overpowered in a sense, while also being very easy to use to call it brain dead. Because sure, like, something can be really easy to play, but if it like fucking sucks and it's not good, then like it's not really brain dead, you know what I mean? Like, as a lot of people would refer to in terms of the connotation. So to start off with, I think we should just basically give the definition. It's the easiest class to play, but with the best results, right? So for starters, we're going to be talking about the dagger classes. Off the bat, I'm going to remove Spy and Bard because these classes alone, they don't really offer that much in terms of damage. Yeah, you have your Snarf Spy, dude, but like anything with Snarf is really good and you can spam Snarf on any class. So I'm going to like take out classes that have Snarf for this video. So just off the bat, like Spy is already reduced by like 50 points in how brain dead it can be. Now Faceless, yeah, Faceless can do a lot of damage. But I think you actually have to play it right because it's really squishy, even though it's really fast. You know what I mean? Like, there's a reason why you can macro it. Like, you know what I'm saying? Now, if you're a macro faceless, sure, you can say that shit's brain dead. But for a majority of people, and especially because we're not considering shit like macros, you know what I mean? Like, you got to hit those combos. You're just going to get one comboed by like an Oni or a Solens or some shit like that, dude. Now, for Shinobi, I think, on the other hand, it's actually pretty easy to pick up. And I actually think it has a lot smaller of a skill gap than Faceless, in my opinion, because, I mean, all you have to do is just point your mouse, grapple, 3, 4, 5, you know, triple dagger throw, shadow rush, arrow slash. Bam, dude, you're like pretty much every other Shinobi in Gaia. And then, you know what I mean? Res is also pretty helpful. So I think it's very powerful, has a lot of mobility. I mean, like, let's just say you're getting comboed up, shadow rush, grapple up into like, you know, a wall and climb away. A lot of people can learn it like in like 10 minutes. I kid you not. So I think I'll put on like the contenders list for the most brain dead. For all the sword classes, I think they have a pretty sizable like skill difference between like the really good and the really bad. Starting off with Abysswalker, it's really easy to play, but I actually think that it's also hard to do well. So they don't really produce effective results in ganks because like a lot of the time, like their moves, you know, big AoE, you know, if somebody's comboing up, you kind of have to be the one going in. Essentially, what I'm trying to say is like those big AoE moves and the lack of spells just kind of makes it not that great for like team ganks, which is why you never see it in ganks anymore. And so if you're really good at it and you want to be really effective, you actually have to be pretty good at Abyss. Ronin, I think it's the same thing. You got to know your combos and shit. I don't think anybody has complaints about that. Solens, I think it's the same thing. A lot of people do think Solens is really powerful, but again, like you got to be in the right scenario. You got to know what to do. Like obviously you can't be one Solens fighting like four Shinobis. Like you're just going to get comboed the fuck out of. You got to know, you know, when's the right situation to actually go in. You can't, it's not just like a Shinobi where you can just go in and hop away. And when it comes to DSK, I don't think it's that crazy hard to learn, but it's just not that super effective in ganks. So I don't think I see a lot of people calling, yo, DSK is so brain dead. Then there's Blacksmith. A lot of people do say like what Blacksmiths do is pretty brain dead and they can produce powerful results, but like more than like two people, Blacksmith isn't really going anywhere. So I don't think a lot of people really have an issue with that one either. Spear classes, I don't think I need to say much about this either. Deep Knight, I mean, it can do good work, but like a lot of people don't really think of Deep Knight as brain dead, so I think I can just go over that one. I can see why some people would call D-Slayer brain dead, but I think it has a lot more complexity than people give it credit for. A lot of people immediately think, yo, Fair Frozen, Navarin, dude, like, dude, Light Piercer, you're just doing the same shit. But, you know, like a really good Fair Frozen, Navarin, D-Slayer, you know, I mean, you gotta know your shit, man. Like, I think it's harder to play than some of the dagger classes to do it right, you know what I mean, to actually be like super effective. But you know, maybe you could argue with me on that, but I don't think it's the most brain dead for sure. Now for the fist classes, Oni, do we even really talk about Oni? Like, you know, you gotta know your Oni combos pretty well, and move stacking is not that hard, but it takes a lot more thought than just, you know, using Demon Flip M2 and then Rising Dragon, or else you're just gonna get pieced up by like a fucking No Tomeless D Sage and get one comboed. Oh, wait. But yeah, for the most part, I think Oni, you gotta really know what you're doing. D-Sage as well, actually, because of the new, like, M2 nerf, you can't just do the branded combo. You actually have to, like, use your skills effectively and know when's the right time to, like, pop monastic stance, you know, actually utilize stacking your M2s with your, like, spells, for example, if they miss. I think there's a lot more that goes into those classes than just, like, what it was before. So I think D-Sage isn't the most brain dead. Now for the mage classes. All right, I think first off, they all automatically become contenders on this list because when it comes to mage classes in general, using spells is really not that difficult. Add Hoppa and like all the god spells, even easier to use these classes. Whenever you get in danger, hop away. And you could basically argue for each one of these why they could be the most brain dead. Starting off with Necromancer. Now with Necromancer, yeah, you got your fucking bounds. You can spam them shits. You have your Cursed Sword, all you need to do is just Action Surge and then switch to one, you know what I mean? And then start using your Shriekers, start using your spells. It's really not that crazy difficult to use and be effective in ganks. And if you do start getting outnumbered, Hoppa, Snap Hoppa. With Druid, actually, Druid, yeah, you do have like a little bit of tech because, yeah, you have to M2 and then you have to use Ignis. However, a lot of times it's like the same combo over and over again. Like once you Ignis them, you Fluoresco, then you actually... Like, a lot of them are doing the same exact thing over and over. And then Illusionist, it's literally just Dominus. And then, there you go. Like, that's it. Just Dominus, man. Like, that's all you fucking need to do. So, I think when it comes down to the most brain-dead class in Gaia, we can automatically cut it down to three classes and Shinobi, I guess. I think when it comes down to, like, non-mage classes, Shinobi's probably the most brain-dead, in my opinion. However, when you include the mage classes, I think these easily take the top, like, three. And if I had to give my own personal opinion on what's the most brain-dead, my personal choice would be Necromancer. Some may argue Druid or even Illusionist, and, you know, that's actually perfectly fine opinions as well, I think. But I think when it really comes down to it, like, Necromancer, dude, just spamming bounds. Like, literally any situation you're in, if you have, like, 100 bounds, dude, it's almost impossible to die if you have bounds and Hoppa, dude. Like, literally gate to snail if you're in danger. That's it. If you're in danger, oh shit, pop a couple bounds, gate, go to snail, pop like a couple more bounds, and then you're out of there, dude. Like, you literally can't die. You could say the same thing about Druid and Illusionist too, but I do think like you got to be a little bit more careful if you're an Illusionist at Aura's Fall, dude. Like, you don't really have those bounds to protect you, or you know, as a Druid, you don't really have that extra protection with those bounds, in my opinion. But yeah, again, this is just my opinion on what's the most brain dead. Leave your comments down below. Maybe you think, fuck it, dude, Blacksmith really is the most brain dead, dude. Again, like, this is just my opinion. I just want to know your guys' thoughts in the comments down below. That's really all going to be it for today's video. I'll see you guys later. Peace.